pedestrians on both sides of the road here, looking for this emerge from that vehicle there. And looking beyond the habitation, you can see where from a right-hand bend, you've got two motorcycles parked on the off-side. A pair of cyclists on the off-side, on that pavement area. Good to be drawn back out, down that scanner, a habitation. Across the national speed limit sign. The speed of the machine. Bear in mind that we're warned of this junction to the offside, which I've checked and cleared, doesn't afford danger. Being drawn out into the area of agriculture, scanning out from the 9 through to the 3 o'clock positions. The habitation, slightly damp section of roadway, although it's drying off nicely, you can see that there is a damp section that runs all the way down the white line down the middle. At this time it is a normal centre line marker, which just changed to hazard warning line with long markers and short gaps. So we'll be looking for an associated hazard ahead at 12 o'clock on the hillside. Bearing in mind that we're warned of the deer, you can see at 12 o'clock on the hillside the road's coming back from the slight left hand bend down from the hill and back towards us on the right hand bend. I link both these corners by going into one, apex in the next, and then coming to the better part of the centre line. It's a zone of invisibility, so it's coming to the centre of the road here. We come round this left hand bend. I come back from the right, so see the check my near side mirror, and come to the part of the 12 to 18 inches from the road debris at the near side. The 9 o'clock position, you've got the holes for the snow, scattered areas of habitation, ploughed fields there, the junction to the near side is checked. Drawn back towards us from this right hand bend, and as you look across the field you can see the orange digger in the field there. It may be associated to roadworks on our road. In fact, 12 o'clock in the middle distance you can see a red vehicle moving away from us, gives us a line on our road. It could be ours, and if it is, then our road will be drawn right towards the left hand side. Checking the offside mirror, position to the left of the centre line. We have a warning sign for the junction to the offside, where that digger is. It appears to be in the field. It's not moving at the moment, but there may be associated roadworks vehicles around it, and I'll be looking for them on the approach. Coming back from this left hand bend, and as anticipated, it is coming back from that road that I mentioned earlier, from that red vehicle. You can see that there's an area of planted trees on the 11 o'clock position on the hillside, the far distance. Coming back from this left hand bend. Mirrors frequently, as it's just as important to know what's behind you as it is to know what's ahead. We're away from the centre line at the moment because the roads have got a bit of visibility, and as we crest the brow of the hill, you can see that it's coming back from a slight right hand bend. It disappears over into the zone of invisibility again, so sees a position myself in the centre position, just slightly to the right of the centre of the road. Careful not to run over the oil, grit and debris that's not been washed away by other road traffic. Out to the 2 o'clock position, you can see a white bus running parallel with us. It is approaching our road, so we're anticipating a junction up ahead that we may encounter that bus. Now as we come over the top of the rise on the hill, you can see that at the 11, 12 o'clock position you've an area of habitation. If we're being brought towards this, then you may find that the speed limits may be reduced. Anticipated, there is an advanced direction sign for that junction on the off-site. We're going to reach it before the coach, so it doesn't afford us any danger. There's a finger post sign for it. The road's coming back from a slight right-hand bend. Get my offside mirror after the oncoming vehicle. I'll bring my machine to the left of the centre line. Now we're being drawn downhill towards this area of habitation, so I'll be anticipating that the old police car there will be because we're being drawn downhill, applying my brakes to come into green law at 30 miles per hour. Vehicles on the offside, so we're looking for vehicles on my side of the road being forced out to overtake them. In a built up area, we've got parked vehicles on the near side. Positioned slightly to the near side here, getting a good view around that bend because of the parked vehicles, and I'll be anticipating vehicles on the open carriageway being forced onto my side of the road, and as anticipated, two vehicles in our line. Drawn out of this built up area, I can anticipate that the speed will increase as we look out into the area of culture. Field up at the 12 o'clock position. We'll be looking for any associated vehicles which to the near side as well. As I bring my speed up to the national speed. Vehicle preceding us, you can see the white roof off the vehicle through the hedge row, which gives us a line of the road up ahead. It's coming back from a slight right hand bend around this left corner. There is the warning sign for that right hand bend, and it's warning us to reduce our speed as we approach it. A lot of road coming off, a lot of water coming off the hillside to the off side of the road, and I'll be riding, or adopting a different riding position on the road should the hillside increase on my side of the road. I'm back from a zone of invisibility, but an advance given no clue. Trees and hedgerows give a good indication of where the road's going to come back from, but on this occasion, it's not until we clear this hill rise that you can see it's coming back from a slight left-hand bend. There's an advanced direction sign for the junction, so it sees a turn both mirrors, reducing my speed until I've got eye contact with this driver on my near side. I have got eye contact, speed's correct here too, and I'm applying a light degree of acceleration. From a slight left-hand bend, casting your eyes out, you can see those hills I've mentioned earlier on. Agricultural farmland, focus on habitation. The junction to the near side, so we're checking that out.